with the bodies and that. Oh, fuck.
And the place is still crawling with security. What exactly are they guarding? They haven't even started on the restoration.
Oh, shit, I didn't even think of that. Anyway, what am I looking for, Bags?
Any kind of device or component that could still be emitting the signal. It seems to be coming from within the rubble.
Take this down. The tone bombing presents us with an excellent opportunity. Once we've taken full possession of the site, it gives us a good vantage point on the Thames and provides us with a cover of activity to mask some of our own higher risk activities.
Spiderbot.
What the hell?
This is it. The signal is coming from this Spiderbot fragment. No indication yet who it belongs to.
Oh, fuck. It looks like my mum after quiz night. What happened to it, though?
Difficult to say, but with an AR reconstruction, we may be able to see what happened to it and if it relates to the attack. Access data relays in the vicinity, and I can compile enough data to build the AR reconstruction.
Looking to automate our jobs, mate. This is no joke. Director Cass. Are you serious? Who told you that?
Friend over in R&D. That
shit he's told me about background checks and knowing who's going to be useful to Harbier, who's going to be a problem.
You ain't worried about your job. This is a PNC. They already do background checks on all of us.
I don't get it. He was talking about the...
Perfect. Two more data relays to go. Data relay and I'll have it.
What?
This stream and the video from D36 and got it. Go back to where you found that Spiderbot and I'll show you the AR reconstruction from the night of the explosion.
Alright, cool.
Data reconstruction in progress.
You brought the payload?
What, think we'd go back for you?
Don't trust the Kelly dog.
Days, you telling me Clan Kelly gangsters thunder bombing?
Oh, I've seen this on my murder shows. It's like a handoff. Kellys are just their suppliers.
Cuz, look, they clearly ain't with Clan Kelly. Does that mean they're with Zero Day?
Well, don't just stand there. Keep looking.
Do a scan or something.
I've now fully decrypted the signal the Spiderbot is broadcasting, and while I cannot identify a specific user, it is a call code used by the Metropolitan Police Service.
Christ, so the police force witnessed this handoff?
The reconstruction continues behind that rubble.
Yo, what if we could just, like, quantum leap through this shit, huh? That'd be wicked.
Quantum tunnel technology is at least 10 years away, but Spiderbots and drones are here today. You could try one of those if you don't feel like waiting.
Ah, bless, bruv.
Why don't you aim those human eyeballs of yours at the van's cargo?
Yeah, got it.
RDX nitrogen, and the exact same detonator system like the bombs that were planted at Parliament.
Ah, that's Zero Day's signature.
Hurry. We've got all the deliveries.
Ah, what we got here?
So you were hired to supply all the targets?
Here. We're all on need to know.
Yo, Zero Day had multiple crews running this shit. Kellys were just a cog.
That's certainly one way to pull off a massive coordinated attack while remaining anonymous. Zero Day needed manpower and resources, but they needed them at an arm's length. And it doesn't take the world's greatest AI detective to see that both Clan Kelly and Albion benefited in the aftermath. Unfortunately, this is the most we can get out of the AR reconstruction. But if we could find the mystery officer who was spying through the Spiderbot, maybe they could tell us more. Tracing the Spiderbot serial number, it was assigned to New Scotland Yard 3 years ago. Perhaps more information about its user or its assignment will be available at the station.
Ah, it's fucking bullshit, man. The feds knew it wasn't that set that did the bombings, but they kept letting everyone believe it.
The only way to know for sure is to investigate New Scotland Yard.
See this? Albion's taken over Scotland Yard.
And the entire police service. But don't worry, if you're not pleased with your privatized goon squad, just take your business across the street.
I mean, fuck the feds, but fuck Albion too, man. Fuck all of this.
Not to worry, the only difference now is the uniform, assault weapons, and the fact they're motivated by profit over public service. Now, any record or information on the Spiderbot will be further in.
strikes, is this the right Spiderbot?
According to the serial numbers, this matches the piece of Spiderbot from the Tone bombing site.
Can you peep who last used it?
Navigate the Spiderbot from out of that room. I'll need a direct connection in order to learn more from our bisected friend.
Ah, cool, I'm all over it.
That opening right there looks like a good exit point. Right, get comfy. This Spiderbot might be broken and missing some of its legs, but it can still jump and fit through vents. That's a good way to get through the station undetected. That's a part of the remote detonator system from Parliament. If the Met, or Albion rather, actually analysed it, they would see it wasn't DedSec's handiwork at all. That's Galton's mask. It must have been recovered from Parliament. It might be the only thing left of him now. Look at all this junk. You'll have to jump your way across to get to the next vent opening. almost there. Make your way through this large fence park.
Through the bat swords.
Yep, got it.
Scanning Spiderbot and accessing its internal drives. While I'm analyzing this data, you should make yourself scarce. Unless you'd like to explain to your new, heavily armed, privatized police force why you've broken into the station.
Sure, whatever.
The Spiderbot fragment you found has a satellite-based GPS module that regularly pushed its location to a specific ground station.
Come on, Bags, don't leave me hanging. Where do we go?
Pushing you the ground station's coordinates.
That's a way in, Bags.
I'm detecting a surveillance network guarding a space under this bridge. If you can patch into it, perhaps you can take a look inside. The GPS history of the Spiderbot we recovered regularly pings these coordinates. Our mystery witness to the real bombers must have come to this lovely, damp location several times.
That's a good spot to do some shady shit.
Or to discreetly dump a body into the Thames.
This can't be the only one of these, like.
Not that the only way.
Hey, check this shit out. It's the fucking Batcave down here, but for like cops or whatever.
Well, if Albion was stomping all over your workplace, you'd find a different place to store your lunch too. And it seems our mystery officer was dedicated.
So how'd they end up sniffing around the tone bomb?
The computer's dusty enough to kill an asthmatic, but there may still be something useful on it.
This is Inspector Caitlin Lau. Well, former inspector now, since Albion's coup. The Met is no more. The police brass had already buried the evidence anyway. Everything implicating Albion and Clan Kelly in the bombings. But I know Mary Kelly's band of twats were involved, and they're involved in other crimes we can look into. Me and a few good mates are willing to go off book, going after Mary Kelly again. I'll never fucking learn, will I?
Inspector Caitlin Lau, video log. Clan Kelly and Albion are teamed up on some deal. I don't have all the details, but it looks to be human trafficking. The European Processing Center is the Albion angle. Since the bombings, they can grab anyone off the street. Call them illegal immigrants, potential dead-sec insurgents, whatever. Though we know who the real danger is. So, Clan Kelly gets hold of these people, these immigrants, deportees, victims, really, and they're taking them somewhere. But where and why? It all comes back to the boss lady herself. I knew she was into something, but she wriggled off the hook. There's only one way I can do this. 24/7 surveillance on Mary Kelly. If I'm caught, well, this will be my last entry. But I have to see what she's hiding.
So, our mystery officer was Inspector Caitlin Lau. It sounds like Mary Kelly was her white whale, and her investigation led her to the bombings.
Wait, so Albion's in with Clan Kelly? Man, fuck defense. I've been saying that forever.
It seems like Zero Day's web covers all of the unsavory bits of London. Tug on a thread, and it leads back to them. Clan Kelly and Albion included.
Snatching people off the streets? Bro, that's so fucked up. You know what? Let's do something about it.
Inspector Lau mentioned Albion is running their part of the operation out of the EPC. Detectives like us call that a lead.